Good morning, everybody. Today, we're going to present about how does color blindness work. My name is Sophia.
My name is Tu.
My name is Liu.
My name is Paul.
So the first thing we're going to talk about is how does color blind, how does the eye see different colors. So we need to understand how does our eye perceive color before we understand how color blindness works. So our eye see different color by receiving light that is bounced off the object. Some light are absorbed by the object, while some are reflected. This reflected light gives the object its color. For example, a banana. So the full spectrum of light will fall on that banana, and almost all of those light will be absorbed except one, which is the yellow light, which will be reflected, and then it will then enter your eyes, where there is specialized cells which will send the information or the light to your brain. Your brain will then receive the information and process it, and then tell you about the color, like it's yellow, it's green, and all that kind of stuff. So, the specialized cells in your eyes are called photoreceptors. There are two types of photoreceptors in your eyes, which are called rods and cones. Rods and cones are called rods and cones because they look, because of their shapes, they look like a rod and a cone, and they are both located in the back of your eyes. And they have completely different functions, and they work in different situations. So the first one we're going to talk about are rods. Rods are the one who are more sensitive comparing to cones. It is more sensitive to light and dark shapes and movements. There are about 120 million rods in your eyes, and most of them, like all of them, only work in dim light. They can't work in bright light, and they aren't very good for color visions. So when you're in a dark room, you're mainly using your rods to see. That's why it aren't allowed to see any color. So when you're in a dark room, you only see in black and white. So cones work completely different. They are responsible for your color visions. It allows you to see color. So there are 6 to 7 million cones in your eyes, and they are responsible for your color visions, and they are not as sensitive as rods. And there are 3 types of cones in your eyes, and these 3 types represent 3 primary colors that you can see, which are red cones, green cones, and blue cones. In your eyes, there are about 64% of them are red cones, 32% are green, and only 2% are blue. And when people are affected with color blindness, one or more of their cone types fail to work, resulting them in not being able to see other color, which is color blindness. Now Liu's going to explain about each different type of color blindness and which cone is not working to cause them.
Yes, what are some type of color blindness? There are many different types of color blindness and also different degree of severity. For people with normal vision, all of three cones are working properly, allowing them to see all that color. When no cones are working correctly, it is known as tichromacy. When all three types of cones are presented, but one of them are defective, causing the eye to be unable to see that color, the cone is seen. This kind of color blindness is called anomalous tichromacy. When all three types of cones are presented, there are three types of anomalous tichromacy. The first one is photanomacy. That red we cannot see the color red very well. The second one is duchromacy, most common type and also red silver. Green we cannot see the color green very well. The third one is dichromacy. Rarest type, blue weak, cannot see the blue very well. Photanomaly and deuteromaly are collectively called as green red color blindness. When people are colorblind with anomalous tichromacy, it doesn't mean that they aren't able to see only that color. For example,
Photonomasi is light cone, more function. It doesn't mean that they can see only light, but all other colors that have light as the component, such as purple. Next type of color, and this is example. It is normal and it is albinist. Next type of color blindness is dichromacy. Dichromacy is when one type of cone is completely missing, and it will result in total absence of that color. This is a more serious condition comparing to anomalous dichromacy. There are also three types. These are deuteranopia, that's no green cone. And the second is photanopia. There's no red cone. And the last one is titanopia, no blue cone. Another type of color blindness is monochromacy. People with monochromacy cannot see any color at all. They see things is only black, white, and shade of gray. This is an extremely rare condition, and it can really make life difficult for people to have it. The next one is,
this is an example of monochromacy, where you cannot see any color at all and only see in black and white.
What's called color blindness? Color blindness is usually a genetic condition. Most people with color blindness are born with it, and it is inherited from their parents, mostly their mother. Inherited color blindness is more common in men than women. It affects approximately 1 in 20 or 12 men, or 80%, and 1 in 200 women in the world. If you have inherited color blindness, your condition will stay insane throughout your life. It won't get any better or worse. However, it is not only an inherited condition, and you can get it without the gene too. And acquired color blindness is often caused by a long-standing disease such as diabetes, multiple sclerosis, some liver disease, and almost all eye disease. Some cause of acquired conditions are chronic illness, accident, medications, industrial or environmental chemicals, and age.
So the next one for us is going to talk about why color blindness is more common in men.
Why is color blindness more common in male than females? Color blindness is more common in male than when women, because it is part of mother to child on the 23 chromosome or the sex chromosome. It is called sex chromosome, because it is the one that determines it. It is made up of two parts which are either 2X if you are female, and X and Y if you are male. The gene which causes color blindness is already carried by the X chromosome. For male is to be colorblind to color blindness. Gene only has to appear on this X chromosome. only need the gene on their chromosome and they are color blind. For male, the gene must appear on both of their X chromosome to make them color blind. So, if a woman has only one X with the gene, that won't be color blind, but there will be a carrier of the gene because male have one X and one Y. X from their mother and Y from their father. Color blindness can only be inherited from that mother. Male only needs only one X with the gene to be color blind, and this is why it is a lot more common for them to be color blind.
So that is the end of our presentation about color blindness. Thank you.